Alright guys, so in this video I want to show you my workflow on taking photos with my iPhone and then retouching them on my desktop on my Lightroom. Not Lightroom Classic, but Lightroom. So let's get started. Alright, first I want to show you my workflow of how I actually take the photos. So what I do is I go to Lightroom Mobile. And very important, I use the professional mode. So of course, I'm an Adobe Creative Cloud subscriber, and so I have that option where when I take a photo, it goes automatically because I'm logged in to my Lightroom account. But I want to shoot them raw. That's very important. You see up here, it says DNG. You want to make sure that's not very, very important, that it's not on JPEG, but on DNG up here. Also, then once you've done that, then it's just like any camera. You're shooting RAW, so you can decide the white balance. So I can go here to white balance, and I can take like daylight, and then I can go to my, so you, the first thing that I do is I go to the lowest ISO possible. See ISO, which is 40 in this case, because the sensor is so small with an iPhone, you really want to get the best possible, you know, details. And for that, you have to have the lowest ISO. Then I just play around because it's a fixed aperture. There's nothing you can do about that. So I just look at the speed and I take whatever speed I want until I get a good exposure. And then I always put the self timer on. See, it says 2 seconds. So for that, you go up there and you go to timer and you put 2 seconds. Why? Because I don't want to touch my camera when I take a shot. Makes sharper photos. And I click, so it goes 1, 2, boom. And it takes the shot. And here's the shot. We're in Paris shooting the Eiffel Tower. And then once you're back in Lightroom, you can see here on the left side, you have a menu and you have all the photos by date. Okay. And then, so what I did is I, for example, if I go here, I can take a photo like this one and I can say, oh, I can say right click and add one photo to, I made what we call a target album. So I made an album here in Lightroom, and this album has set interior Sony versus iPhone, that was the name of the album, as the target album. So you do that, and then you can go through all your photos. So I went through all my photos, and so you got all my Lightroom photos there. Every time I take a photo, it's there, and I can press T, and it puts it into the album. Then I go to the album, and I can start my retouching. So I'll show you on this one. Now the workflow is very similar to Lightroom Classics. You can do it with your fingers on your phone or you can do it on your desktop. I like to do it on the desktop on a big screen. And you know, and the name of the game is always the lowest ISO possible. So if I press I can see this was shot at ISO 40. Check this out. This was a very dark photo. I shot it with my iPhone 12, ISO 40, you know, at 1/80th of a second. So let's see, it should be can you imagine doing that with your phone? It's really crazy. So when it comes to phone photography, I don't do the open the shadow 100% and bring down one. I don't do as much because it's not, the RAW files are not as powerful than with my Sony camera or my Fuji. So usually I open the shadows about midways and I crush the highlights midways. But I still hold down the option key on my keyboard to crush the blacks. Okay, that's about that. And then I do something to crush the whites, which is like that. And then on this one, I'm just gonna boost a bit the exposure. And because it was raw, I can go here and I can choose different white balance. I can go to daylight, I can go to cloudy, I can go to shade. You see, but shade is making it darker. So daylight, I think, is the best. I'm just gonna add a bit of magenta because I'm a magenta addict. I'm seeing somebody about that. Hope, you know, I can resolve it. But for now, I add magenta everywhere. Maybe add a bit. What I don't want is I don't want the blue to turn into gray. So that's why I go for daylight and I add a bit of magenta. I'm not going to touch vibrance and saturation because it's good. And you can see here the before and after. Before and after. And let's zoom in. And it's actually pretty, it's a bit noisy. So, okay, when it comes to noise, let's go to the noise detail. And usually what I do on this one is I'm going to, I'm already at 10 noise reduction, so I might go to like 15. And I'm gonna open this detail here and I'm gonna put the mask in. Now that's very important. If you hold on the option key and you do the masking, You can see anything which is black is not gonna get sharpened. I don't want any sharpening on the sky, so I'm gonna mask a lot. Yeah, something like that. Okay, so masking, and then I can boost the sharpening. Usually what I do is I take number 100. Now with the iPhone, I do a bit less. I take like 80. I minus out my noise reduction, so that would be like 65, and I go like at 65 with sharpening. And now I got a pretty sharp photo, and I could actually make a print with this. Okay, let me show you another example. This is my good friend Natalie. We were at Death Valley. It's an overexposed photo. Let's look at the settings. I shot this, I think it was a JPEG. No, DNG, I did shoot it RAW, but it's 32 ISO, so that's good, but it's a little too overexposed. So that's fine. Let's see what we can do here with a beautiful Lightroom. Oh, by the way, guys, before I do this retouching, if you like this video, please smash, destroy the like buttons. It really helps me. It just takes a second. You just click on it. Other people can see the video. Thank you so much. Leave me a comment. Tell me what you want to learn. I'm trying to play a game to make 2 videos per week. I'm going crazy on YouTube. So just tell me. I read all your comments every day. I'm obsessed by your comments. I read them all the time. So tell me what you would like to learn on Lightroom, on Photoshop, on photography, on the business photography, on being an artist. Whatever you know you want to learn, let me know. And I'll do my best to fulfill your wishes. Also, if by any chance you're not subscribed, please subscribe, come on. All this free content just for you. I've done over 800 YouTube videos. You can get a lot of really cool things. It's kind of like a daily show you can watch. And I know people who watch it every week, and it can really, really improve your photography. It did for many people. I have so many friends who are not professional photographers just from watching the YouTube channel. So just subscribe. It may change your life, or it may not. All right, so let's get back here. Oh, by the way, the true way I retouch my photography is using presets. So I go here, I got all my natural everyday presets, and this was a golden hour shot, so I would use one of these presets and just click and then do some adjustments. And you can get most of my free presets down under this video. You can get my toolbox. The toolbox is like 40 free presets. It's textures, it's skies, it's profiles. And it comes with like 1 hour of training to show you how to use all that. It's completely free. All I am asking you is to subscribe to my daily newsletter, where you're gonna get a lot of free tips, a lot of free videos, and amazing, amazing, amazing promotion on some of my best courses. So click down the link below, get the free toolbox, install it, watch the training. It's gonna change the way you retouch your photo. All right, but I'm not gonna use a preset since you're watching this. I'm gonna study it from scratch. So this is really an overexposed photo. So again, because it's an iPhone photo, I'm just gonna open the shadows, bring down the highlights like that. I'm gonna crush my blacks and not move my whites. Now the sky, I'm gonna make it really darker. And because it's a RAW file, I still have some details in the sky. So let's use them even more using the gradient tool. The gradient tool, I'm gonna lower the exposure and I'm gonna add some blue. And I'm gonna make a first pass like that. Yes, and I'm gonna make a second one with the same value. So 2 pass, one for the very top, one for the bottom. Maybe I'm gonna make another one here just to sort of close the photo. On this one, I am going to boost a little bit the vibrance because it's really missing some vibrance. And then I'm gonna go to the white balance. And maybe on this one, I wanna go to, let's see, shade. Yeah, shade's pretty cool. And a bit of magenta, yes. Yes, let's see where we are. Before, after, quite some change. Let's add some contrast to it. And I say it's pretty cool for an iPhone, isn't it? I'm gonna make it even darker, boost the whites. I'm just playing around, you know? One thing I love to do when I do phone photography is taking photos of like daylight and turning them into like crazy black and whites. So same thing, the way I do it is I use my presets. So I have this really crazy black and white preset. Check it out. I just go through like this. Wait for it. Bam, bam, bam. Actually, on this one, I'm going to use my preset. Boom. Once you use the preset, and again, this one, this one's included. You can get it down below. Once I get the preset, I can just go here in the gradient, and I can adapt my gradients. Voila. So because I got a gradient for the sky, it's already in there. Oops. Nope. And voila, and you can adjust a little bit. Of course, I can lower the exposure. I'm gonna crush the blacks, but voila. And that took 2 seconds. Check it out, before, after. So if you're not using Lightroom to retouch your Lightroom mobile, iPhone or Android photo, you're missing out. Check it out, get my free preset, and I'll see you in another video. Mesdames et messieurs, au revoir.